Hello everyone. So today we are going to discuss about the paper 1 of MH set, which was conducted on December 27, 2020. So this is the set B of that paper, you can see here. So first 5 questions are related to the passage, which is on higher education and includes the Niti Aayog scheme in it. So we are moving to the questions directly. So first question is, what does the author mean when he says that since the last decade the higher education sector has been occupying a dominant position in economical planning process? So here the answer is, the higher education sector is dominating the other sectors. The second one is, the policy makers in India are taking steps to increase expenditure towards higher education sector because the aim at enabling India to match up to global standards. Here option A is right answer. So we are moving to the third question. The attitude of author towards the teacher is, it is the sympathetic. Option C is the correct answer. The fourth one, the author says that a significant portion of highly educated professionals is stuck in a volatile academic ecosystem because there is a lack of formal law to govern the terms and conditions of the contractual engagement of highly educated professionals. It is option B. We are moving to the last question of the passage. Here they gave the two statements. The first statement is, there is the growth in the number of universities. And the second one is, there is a growth in absolute increase in employment. So as per the passage, statement 1 is the true and statement 2 is the false. We are moving to the sixth question. While defining communication, Miller focuses on behavioral change of the receiver. So option A is the right answer. Serial function of sender in communication cycle are as follows. So in communication process, there will be the two parties, one is the sender and another one is the receiver. So the cycle of sender will be as follows. The first one is, he will collect the data and formulate the information and encodes it and transfers it to the receiver, right? So option A will be the right answer. We are moving to the 8th question. So the components of communication cycle are sender, message, receiver and feedback. So without feedback, communication cycle cannot be completed. So that's why the option D is the right answer for the 8th question. So in the 9th question, which of the following is one of the communications based on the number of the parties? So it is the personal communication. The personal communication will be vary from person to person. Okay. And in the 10th question, the characteristics of mass media communication are large number of audience, heterogeneous audience, scattered audience, and the absence of direct feedback. Because of large number of people, here we cannot get the quick feedback from the people. So the option C is the right answer for the 10th question.